Hello and welcome to another critical reasoning video by Perfect Scores. This is Preetinder Kaur, and the question in front of us is, which of the following, if it occurred, would constitute a disadvantage for HOTCO of the plan described above? So we have to find a disadvantage of the plan. Now the argument is HOTCO oil burners designed to be used in asphalt plants . Now these oil burners are so efficient that HOTCO will sell one to the Clifton Asphalt plant for no payment other than the cost savings between the total amount the asphalt plant actually paid for oil using the former burner during the last 2 years and the total amount it will pay for oil using the HOTCO burner during the next 2 years. So if you put it on the scratch paper, it comes to this: that HOTCO is planning to sell one of its burners to Clifton Asphalt plant. And no cost is there. It is so confident of its own efficiency that it is only going to take the payment in terms of cost savings. And what are the cost savings? The payment that Clifton had to make for oil using the old burners in the past 2 years minus the payment that Clifton has to make for oil on the new burners from HOTCO for the next 2 years. So the difference will be given as this. So basically an amount will be given, an estimated payment, which will be adjusted after 2 years to equal the actual cost savings. So that is the plan. We have to find the disadvantage. Maybe we can find a problem in the calculation, in the way the calculation is done, or maybe we can find a problem in the way the method is used. So A option says another manufacturer's introduction to the market of a similarly efficient burner. That is talking about competition, but once a deal is made between these two, it does not matter. So A is gone. B says the plant's need for more than one new burner. Well, that does not matter because HOTCO is selling only one, and only for that one plant we are talking about the cost savings. So B is gone. C says very poor efficiency in the plant's old burner. That is something that is already known, that the old burner was not so efficient. That is why with confidence HOTCO can say and demand the difference between these two oil payments. So C is gone. D says a decrease in the demand for asphalt. Now that is not of concern for us whether the demand will increase or decrease. We are just talking about this process. E says a steady increase in the price of oil beginning soon after the new burner is installed. Now let's suppose earlier the price was $1 and the plant was using 100 units of oil, so it had to pay $100. Let's suppose due to the efficiency, now it has to use only 50 units, but the price of oil has increased to $2 per unit. So now it will still have to pay $100. So at the end it means there are exactly no cost savings. Isn't that right? So that would be a bad way of finding out if the price of oil increases or decreases. That can change the whole equation. And that is the problem in this plan. And that is why E is your answer. So thank you so much for watching this video.